Hello everyone, Jacob here with Primal Fitness and Sports Performance, back with another video in the Highland Games Indoor Drills Series. Today I'm going to be going over drills for the weights for distance. So this video is going to be combining drills that I use for lightweight distance as well as the heavyweight distance, because they're pretty much all the same. The technique is the same for each of them, so why bother making two different videos for light and heavyweight when I can just show all the drills that I do for both of them in one? So for this, I really like using a kettlebell. You can do these dry, but you won't quite get a feel for how you have to counterbalance the weight while it's swinging around. So I'm just going to be using lightweight today. This is a 30-pound kettlebell. The lightweight for men is 28 pounds, so all you need is a 30 or a 25-pound kettlebell. It's kind of dependent on how I'm feeling this particular day, if I want to go a little heavier or a little lighter. Also, I really like to use a deadlift strap with this, especially being inside. You don't want a kettlebell just randomly flying out of your hand while you're doing this. So, strap it in to the kettlebell. Usually one or two loops around the handle will do. Should be fine that way. The first thing I like to do is just practice my cast or my swings. So I'll start here. Good athletic position. Weight over to my left side. Just gonna swing it up. Swing the front. Back. And around. What I'm really trying to focus on is keeping this movement smooth, not choppy. What I really like to do in the back is try and get a little arm raise. So that'll set up position for the weight to come down and around instead of just swinging it like this right behind you. And if you're doing this just right behind you, all the weight has to go just back out and in. And although that is a great way to initially learn, it really makes the throw itself very choppy, and you have to wait more for the weight to come back around. You have to catch it in the right position to really get into your turn. Again, strap against the kettlebell. Starting with the weight over your left foot, swing back. Back, behind, raise up, and around. So you can see that dipping and pushing, trying to keep my arm out and moving almost in a half circle. So that would be kind of a warm-up thing that I'd like to do, just get to my shoulder ready to be constantly swinging with the weight around. And I will do this for both the heavyweight and the lightweight. Now this next drill, I specifically only use for the lightweight, because I found that trying to do this with the heavyweight, things get real sketchy pretty fast. So this is going to be line drills, where I'm starting to work on getting into my turns and staying balanced, placing my left foot with my right on my initial turn, and then trying to continuously go forward. This. Swing, pass down and around, place right with left, weight still coming around, and all I'm trying to do is stay on balance, keep the weight moving, and progress forward with turns. Turn itself, you want to be pushing off your right while your left place. Turn, push, and release. So again, line drill.
Right foot, so you get back into your one turn position. And then
toe work, nice, fast, and powerful. So this video is going to be the last of the indoor drill series videos. I really hope that these helped out and that you're able to use them if you're still not able to get outside. Thankfully now, I personally am able to get outside. It's constantly down in the 50s where I'm at in Minnesota. Snow is all gone for the most part, but I'm finally able to throw it outside. So if you're able to throw outside, do that. It's so much better for you because you can actually release the stuff. I know that when I was first starting out, if I had some of these different indoor drills to do, that would have probably really helped me. Thankfully, I got in touch with a great group of throwers in the cities, and they really helped me out a lot as well. So I'm just trying to pass on the knowledge that I learned over the last 3 seasons of competing in the Highland Games. Anyone that's just starting to get in, doesn't know where to start for drills, or wants some of the drills that they can do inside. Now I will probably be doing some outdoor stuff, showing some videos of that. Showing some videos of my throwing practice, as well as probably over some different technique stuff as well. It's a lot more fun to show the actual throws and be able to release, and that release itself is a major part of any throwing. You can feel nice and solid in your technique in here with a kettlebell or a PVC pipe, but once you get out and actually try and release and your technique and go back. So here's an example of that right now. So that was my first open song practice of the 2019 season, and I was working on my modified South African inside with a PVC pipe or a medicine ball. I feel very solid in that technique, but then I added in the release. There's a great example of that. I really hope that you enjoyed this series. I think I already said that, I can't remember. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like, comment, share with your friends, subscribe, and hit that notification bell, and do whatever else it is that you do on YouTube. Stay tuned for more videos to come. I will see you all in the next video. Leave a comment.